Microbes around us everywhere, hacking you at any moment, and there is nothing we are able to do about it. Then far the general public do not know how it works or what it's. So before you begin this video, please admire this video and share our channel for future updates. How our system responds to a bacterial infection and to raised understand these phenomena. As an instance that a rusty nail hacked your skin into your first line of defense, which is your physical barrier to skin with this rush, there was plenty of bacteria that invaded your body. So now the system within the body should recognize and fight this bacteria. That the first line of defense is internal immune cells. Internal immune cells. Bacteria. Some of the bacteria that colonize your skin are beneficial and really help keep harmful strains and other forms of pathogens from growing. Bacteria colonize our skin and our systema digestorium. That addresses the primary misconception that you just only find bacteria on contaminated or dirty surfaces. Plenty of bacteria growing there with it. A growing community of mold and bacteria, not ideal for a shower toy. But we do want to say that a lot of times, all bacteria are lumped together as a foul thing, which shouldn't happen, because not all bacteria are bad. In fact, many sorts of bacteria are helpful for organisms and ecosystems. Okay, so what are bacteria exactly? In the three domains of life, bacteria encompass one amongst them. They are available in several styles of shapes, as you'll be able to see here. A number of them are heterotrophs, meaning they consume or kill some organic matter. But some are autotrophs. They can make their own food. Plants aren't the sole one that may be autotrophs. Let's take a glance at a bacterium here. A bacterium could be a prokaryotic cell, which are generally much smaller than eukaryotic cells like ours. That means bacteria don't have a nucleus or other membrane-bound organelles. But you may find ribosomes, cytoplasm, a plasma membrane, and nearly all bacteria have a semipermeable membrane. Like all living organisms, bacteria have DNA. Bacterial DNA, while still double-stranded, is arranged in an exceedingly circular shape. Betting on the species, bacteria may have a flagellum to assist with movement, a capsule which may assist in giving them extra protection or attachment abilities, or pili which might help with attaching to surfaces including one another. Many bacterial species have a plasmid. We do want to say that a lot of times, all bacteria are lumped together as a foul thing, which shouldn't happen, because not all bacteria are bad. In fact, many sorts of bacteria are helpful for organisms and ecosystems. Okay, so what are bacteria exactly? In the three domains of life, bacteria encompass one amongst them. They are available in several styles of shapes, as you'll be able to see here. A number of them are heterotrophs, meaning they consume or kill some organic matter. But some are autotrophs, they can make their own food. Plants aren't the sole one that may be autotrophs. Let's take a glance at a bacterium here. A bacterium could be a prokaryotic cell, which are generally much smaller than eukaryotic cells like ours. That means bacteria don't have a nucleus or other membrane-bound organelles. But you may find ribosomes, cytoplasm, a plasma membrane, and nearly all bacteria have a semipermeable membrane. Like all living organisms, bacteria have DNA. Bacterial DNA, while still double-stranded, is arranged in an exceedingly circular shape. Betting on the species, bacteria may have a flagellum to assist with movement, a capsule which may assist in giving them extra protection or attachment abilities, or pili which might help with attaching to surfaces including one another. Many bacterial species have a plasmid. Which is largely like extra DNA. Bacteria have some intriguing abilities that are different from our human cells that we'd wish to mention. Unlike our own body cells, which perform mitosis and cytokinesis to divide, Bacteria generally multiply even faster in an exceedingly process called binary fission. This is a sort of agamogenesis when the bacteria can easily divide to create a duplicate of themselves. Since it's agamogenesis, the daughter cells would be expected to be similar to the parent cells unless there's a mutation. Bacteria can get a plasmid, an extra version of DNA with usually just some genes on it. Bacteria can share these plasmids with one another in a very process called conjugation. The pili will be want to share this genetic information with one another. If the plasmid happens to possess a gene that offers a point of resistance to an antibiotic, this may allow the bacterium that received the plasmid to survive exposure thereto antibiotic. Bacterial transformation. Bacteria also can acquire plasmids from their environment. Often when this happens, it's during a time of stress for the bacteria. In a very process referred to as bacterial transformation, scientists can use a sort of stimulus such as a heat shock to induce bacteria in an exceedingly lab setting to select up genetic material. There are every kind of those uses for these genetically engineered bacteria that you just can explore. Some forms of bacteria can form endospores. Endospores allow bacteria to be survivors altogether types of hostile environments. Lack of nutrients, freezing temperatures, drought, just some examples. This can be a reason why hospitals must be superb at sterilization processes. The main immunoglobulin immune cells involved in combating bacterial infection are neutrophil cone cells, etc. And now these internal immune components try to eradicate and eliminate these bacteria. Not only are these macrophages or dendritic cells the cell can produce, chemical robberies, called chemokine, that will attract much more immune cells or internal immune cells to the positioning of infection and would create stronger immunity response against these invaders. Now let's study a specific dendritic cell. The dendritic cell may be a phagocytotic cell, a bit like a macrophage, until the bacteria sweep up and also the endosome bacteria fuse with lysosomes, and eventually the bacteria will damage and deviate from them. Inside these materials may well be debris or these components. Eventually displayed on the surface of dendritic cells on class 2 MHC molecules using class 2 the MHC dendritic cell molecules that provide these inputs to T auxiliary cells will now be mobilized towards the military base camp, which is at the node now inside the lymphatic tissue. There are dedicated areas where T cells and B cells find these dendritic cells can activate T cells and thus activate B cells. Or counting on the bacteria themselves can activate B cell directly via endotoxy. T whatever cell B is activated. The last word goal is to spread and make antibodies that the cells can. From the proliferation of those naive cells, the rise in their number eventually gains experience and eventually converts into plasma cells that secrete different models of antibodies against those particular bacteria now once. These antibodies produce these antibodies that may mess with bacteria and make the foremost of those bacteria. Or another word is to neutralize these bacteria so it's difficult for them to affect them. Dendritic cells or NIC cells that have receptors against this are part of these antibodies in order that they will bind their two particular antibody and submerge the pathogen. This can be called antibody-dependent cytotoxicity. If we do not brush enough, they require the maximum amount space as they'll, and that we don't need them to own complex systems within our bodies interact. But we're setting out to see what proportion microbiome actually affects us in our behavior. And in early 2017, a study linked microbiota and intelligence, tests with fruit flies, showed that their microbiome affected the styles of food they were known for. That might mean your microbiome can tell your brain what food to urge, but how they evolve and alter is set by what we eat. Organisms, some styles of bacteria are utilized in producing some foods that we eat. In ecosystems, bacteria have an awfully important role as decomposers. Bacteria even have major roles within the organic process to repair nitrogen that plants need. Bacteria in your systema alimentarium actually help break down food, and a few can produce certain vitamins. The organisms in our intestines go after various things, some like fiber and leafy vegetables. Others opt for sugar and starches, and a few fatty potatoes and butter. Our intuition is sort of a garden during which we constantly decide what is going on to grow and thrive. Bacterial diseases. Bacteria are the explanation for streptococcal sore throat, tetanus, dental caries, some sorts of pneumonia, diphtheria, salmonella, cholera. I could persist. Antibiotics will be want to combat a number of these. And while antibiotics are important for destroying bacterial infections, we shouldn't additionally. There are vaccines which might prevent many varieties of both bacterial and viral infections. If we eat healthily, we generate bacteria that like healthy food. If we eat lots of nutriment, then we generate fast food-loving bacteria. Life is difficult, so we will get trapped in a very positive feedback. You've got an extended time. Eat lots of burgers and fries and pizza. That's great for fast food bacteria as they breed and multiply and take an area of vegetable-loving bacteria. If you enjoyed this video and wanted to inform us your opinion within the comments section below, then listen again. Confirm you press this subscription button before you go. We'll do more digital stuff within the future. Thanks for watching.